This release of Dashboards 2.0 introduces new runtime features that take advantage of the newly released Forms 2.0 in EPM Cloud. To use the new functionality, your application must be set to use Forms 2.0 in Application Settings. For more information on Forms 2.0, see our related video. Enabling Forms 2.0 lets you display data forms in grids in Dashboards 2.0. Notice that the chart type for the top two dashboard components is set to grid. With grids, you can update cell values, run rules, and save your changes. The toolbar for grid components includes a local save button, which saves data for the selected grid and launches any rules that are set to run on save. It also includes an action option to run business rules or smart push operations defined for the grid's data form. The local toolbar for all Dashboard 2.0 components includes a new information icon, which shows the form name, cube, path, description, and instructions. On the Dashboards page, you can now filter your dashboards by type. A new conversion utility lets you convert your dashboards from 1.0 to 2.0. You can convert a single dashboard, all dashboards in a selected folder, including its subfolders, or all dashboards in the application library. Converted dashboards are displayed with the Dashboard 2.0 icon. When viewing dashboards, you can now adjust the width and height of components. Your adjustments persist until the dashboard is reloaded. You can also open or edit a form directly from the dashboard components. Open Form opens a dynamic tab with the form in an ad hoc grid. Edit Form opens a dynamic tab with the form editor, where you can change and save the form layout and options without going into Forms Management. With dynamic tabs, there's no need to close the dashboard, and you can return to it by selecting the dashboard tab again. Right-click a cell in a grid component to select the new Analyze on Cell option. This opens a dynamic tab with the selected data point and its context in an ad hoc grid, where you can conduct further analysis. In the Dashboard Designer, the Dashboard Properties tab now includes a style option, which adds light and dark color schemes for your dashboards. When you save the style change, the runtime dashboard reflects the new style. Rules for valid intersections are supported in Dashboards 2.0 grids. Notice that some rows in the form are grayed out and not editable when I change the point of view based on the defined valid intersections rules. You can now edit dashboards without data. This option is available from the Dashboards page or from the Runtime Dashboard Actions menu. In the Dashboard Designer, you can use the Associations tab to add business rules to your dashboards. When data forms for your components have business rules, the form name is displayed at the top of the list with a special icon. Select the form to enable all form-related business rules for the component in the dashboard. You can also select individual business rules, which you can run at the dashboard level. If you make changes to data in multiple grids in a single dashboard, the Global Save button enables you to write back changes in all your grids at once. Clicking the Global Save button also runs all business rules in the dashboard that are set to run on save. The Rules drawer opens and displays runtime prompts for you to enter or review. Complete the prompts for each rule, then click Launch. Dashboards 2.0 have a new Point of View or POV dropdown. Begin typing a member name in the inline dropdown to shorten and filter the list. You can also invoke the new member selector, where you can display descendant counts, show invalid members, and find a member's location in the hierarchy. Grids in Dashboards 2.0 support Calc on the Fly. When Calc on the Fly is enabled, you can hover over a calculated cell in the grid to view the formula associated with the cell. Calc on the Fly lets you enter data and see calculated results without first having to submit changes to the database. You can enter multiple changes to the grid and immediately see the effects of your changes. A color change indicates modified cell values. Click Save to retain your changes. Finally, you can now design dashboards that have a master component and one or more target components. To filter data in target components based on a master, right-click data in the master and select Apply Context. The selection is reflected in the Detail component. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.